The Met Police have faced a fair bit of scrutiny over the past few weeks, from the public at least. Now, another latest shocking revelation has come to light. This is that a serving officer in the force was a member of a Nazi organization. Now, his name is Benjamin Hannam. He is 22 and from North London. And he was found guilty of being a member of the proscribed organization National Action. Now, this makes him the first British officer to be convicted of a terrorism offence. This is the BBC's Home Affairs correspondent Daniel Sanford confronting Hannam as he left the Old Bailey.
Why did you join a terrorist organisation and then join the police? Why did you join a terrorist organisation and then join the police? Ben, why do you...
That was a very dramatic attempt at an interview. Now, Hannam has been released on conditional bail and is due to be sentenced on April the 23rd. Now, this guy, he spent 2 years in the force working among communities in North London and apparently even interviewing suspects on his own. This is incredibly worrying. We've also got some more details on the timeline of events which led to him managing to become an officer. So he joined National Action in early 2016 while studying his A-levels and remained a member after it was banned under the Terrorism Act. We can see a picture here. In July 2017, he was in this propaganda video spray painting the National Action logo. Now, apparently his application to join the Met began only days after spray painting this. So there isn't a big time difference between involvement in this proscribed organization and joining the Metropolitan Police. Now, one of the BBC journalists reporting on the case shared this detail from 2 months later in Hannam's timeline. So he says, in September 2017, before he joined the Met, counter-terror police seized raw footage of Hannam at group events after the ban. The footage was found during searches of the homes of NA co-founder Alex Davies and a member called Mark Jones. Hannam was not identified. Now, when he applied for the role in the Met in 2017, part of the application involved being asked if he'd been a member of the BNP. The Met do ask, or any other organization which may contradict the duty to promote race equality. Clearly, he shouldn't have ticked no, but he did tick no, and it was that easy. There were some other signs missed in the application process. So the BBC report that a teacher told the trial she had been unable to mark one essay submitted by Hannam, the first time this had happened in 20 years of teaching because of concerning content and his intolerance towards Islam. He was also spoken to after students at his diverse school reacted to anti-immigration views he espoused during a debate. The Met never took a reference from the school. That wasn't the only thing the BBC uncovered. They also uncovered this. During his trial, Hannam told jurors, there are no pictures of me doing a Nazi salute, but we have identified him at a fight training event in August 2016 that was filmed for a National Action propaganda video. What did the group do at the end? He's circled in red doing a Nazi salute, if you're listening to the podcast and can't see him doing it there. Now, this is from a fight training event in the summer of 2016, which was the same summer that National Action glorified the murder of Labour MP Joe Cox. And let's go to a Met comment. So the Met police say, Commander Richard Smith, head of the Met's counter-terrorism command, has said he was hugely concerned that a serving officer had been a member of a banned group, but that he was identified at the earliest opportunity and officers then moved quickly to make an arrest. Now, Aaron, what do you make of this? I mean, on one hand, you can say this is just, you know, one bad egg that they've found and they've managed to take him out and they've charged him. They found him and he's being punished. On the other hand, you could say, how did he manage to join and be a member of the Metropolitan Police for 2 years without anyone sort of raising alarm bells that this guy's a raving, and presumably he's a raving racist if he was a member of National Action? What do you make of it?
Yeah, it's remarkable. And also, you know, for our audience out there, National Action are a serious organization. They're a serious organization. Jack Renshaw, who was found guilty of, I think, conspiracy to commit a terrorist act, something to that effect. He had plans at hand to effectively assault and to murder Labour MP Rosie Cooper in a manner which was similar to what happened with Joe Cox, a copycat killing potentially. Obviously, didn't happen. He was incarcerated for preparing to do that. So very serious organisation. You know, when you're looking at the politics of extremism, somebody has been on a WhatsApp group and they've said something inflammatory or incendiary, or obviously completely unacceptable, still a very nasty, horrible person. But National Action members have been involved in deeply serious stuff. And one can only surmise from that that he was in the police precisely to advance these politics. Because like you say, there's no real time delay here. And I think that does have to beg a broader question, Michael, which is, to what extent are the far right trying to infiltrate the police in this country? Now, there's not many people, you know, National Action, as we understand, that has a membership of potentially 50, 100 people, you know, it's in the dozens. But there's a very strong far right ecology through Telegram channels, now through increasingly through offline meetings and so on and so forth, you know, who use alt tech, whether it's Gab or whether it's a plethora of these other platforms they use, BitChute. So I think that's the first question for me, which has to be asked. Are there others? How many of them? And like you say, that has to be a join to the question you posed me, which is, how did he get this far? How did it take so long? By the way, he was only uncovered because there was a leak of the membership data of National Action. The police managed to get hold of this leak, and then they went one by one through the members, and they realized that one of them was working for the Metropolitan Police Force. So Metropolitan Police Service, rather. So it was actually entirely fortuitous. And I suspect there are many, many others. And of course, we know from experience elsewhere in Germany, in Greece, there has been a significant infiltration by the police of organized far-right groups, whether it's the Golden Dawn in Greece. Equally in the United States, obviously a long history of the Klan, far bigger than anything we've had over here, thank goodness, infiltrating the police in states historically associated with racism, Jim Crow laws, and so on. So I just want to impress that point. This is really serious, and it feeds into a broader international pattern. And I don't know how the police can deal with it, because frankly, I find it remarkable that the only reason why this guy's been caught after several years is down to luck, down to a leak. You know, and I think we have to work on the presumption there are at least several other people just like him in the police. And I think clearly his entire record as a serving officer, I think he was probationary officer for almost all of his time as an officer in the Met. I think clearly every single case he's been involved with now has to be reviewed. Did none of his colleagues bring up his behavior? We know, for instance, that a teacher, and this is remarkable, it wasn't caught by the Met, a teacher said that he was deeply concerned by his political views. This was when I think he was in sixth form. He briefly goes to university after a month or two, after a very short period of time, he joins the police force. So a teacher can ascertain he has really troubling political views, but nobody in the Metropolitan Police Service identifies that after 2 or 3 years. No colleagues, no line managers. That speaks to a very degenerate culture inside the police when it comes to racism. Deeply, deeply concerning. I think personally, we have to have, at the very least, a big public inquiry around this. But I think also, you know, politicians from all sides, Labour, Tories, and so on, need to go all in here. Now, it's not a pile on into the Met, which I think they should do anyway, given what's going on with Sarah Everard and a bunch of other stuff, public order policing, the proposed new bill that's coming through. But we need to be really attentive here now to the possibility of the far right trying to enter the police force in an organised way. The army as well. This is what they have done in many countries over many decades. Can't be taken lightly.